John Galliano, accused of hurling anti-Semitic abuse at a couple in a cafe. He says,
"What's up, blacks? I mean, what's up, blues? It's your girl, AV Late Night, back again for another hilarious video. That was a joke. Don't report me. Let's move on. If you didn't already know, I am one of the most woke YouTubers on the platform, specifically in the DMV, so I've been told. And we're just gonna jump right into today's video. I know there's been a lot of recent controversy. There's been a lot of talk about Gucci and Prada and some of and some controversial designs that they revealed to the public. So I thought it was a pretty cool idea to talk about some designs and some designers that face a lot of backlash after releasing racially insensitive products into the world. So let's get started. Since Gucci's in the hot seat right now, if you didn't already know, February of this year, Gucci released a new $890 sweater. Resembles blackface and a lot of the stereotypical designs that you would see of black people, like in the early, back in the day when people were really, really racist. I'm not good with dates. After immediately dropping on social media, the $900 turtleneck was instantly facing issues. People on social media were going crazy, specifically black people. Yeah, a lot of us. Gucci issued a statement like a week later saying, "We are fully committed," and this is how I think people at Gucci sound because they're so fancy and rich. "We are fully committed to increasing diversity throughout our organization and turning this incident into a powerful learning moment for the Gucci team and beyond." T.I., Spike Lee, Daniel Day all spoke out against the brand, basically saying, "And you're canceled, sis." Well, December of 2018, Prada released these little monkey keychains that, like Gucci, resembled blackface. It's so crazy how big lips were like a black thing back in the day, but now everybody wants Kylie Jenner lips, and that's the tea, sis. Of course, the little blackface monkeys were pulled off of shelves immediately, and Prada issued a statement. They were gonna form a diversity council so things like this don't happen again. But honestly, as big as corporations like Gucci and Prada are, you think they would already have diversity councils so things like this don't happen in the first place. And they also spoke out with a statement saying, "We will help ensure that the fashion world is reflective of the world in which we live in." Yeah, the world is really racist, so you guys are doing a great job. Keep up with the products. This next designer we're gonna talk about did not release a product, but a very racially insensitive campaign. Dolce & Gabbana, in November of last year, which was right before the Gucci controversy, released a campaign called DG Loves China. The campaign was one of their Korean models trying to pick up Italian food with chopsticks. That's not cute. As you can see, the Asian community was outraged. And the rabbit hole goes even deeper with supermodels Bella and her sister Gigi Hadid mocking Asian models and their facial features. They put it on Snapchat, which was soon deleted. D&G was already in trouble for their campaign, and then they post a Snapchat that is already mocking Asian people yet again, so it didn't blow over well at all. Who can't forget the oh-so scandalous H&M scandal that happened January of 2018? The H&M brand sported a new campaign of a little boy on their website wearing a little green sweatshirt that said "coolest monkey in the jungle." It wasn't cute. It wasn't really cute at all. H&M had, I want to say, the biggest backlash of all the designers that we've talked about, just because they had a lot of high profile celebrities such as like G-Eazy, The Weeknd, drop their line completely. Like Prada, H&M followed suit and hired a diversity consultant. Like I said before, I don't understand how these huge clothing companies don't already have diversity councils to make sure that, you know, they're not being racist or their underlying racial tendencies aren't coming out through their clothing. But that's fashion nowadays. Moving on. And who could forget December of 2018 when fashion company Chanel hosted their métier. What word is that? I don't speak French.
Métier d'art.
The models were sporting what seemed to be like Jackson 5 apparel, but Native American headdresses. So altogether, it was really just weird and bizarre. Chanel further spoke out about the controversy, saying that it was a show in Dallas and Native American culture has a huge part in Dallas history. history, and they were trying to pay tribute to Native Americans, but there was not a single Native American in the show. Ha! There wasn't even black people in the show. It was all Caucasian females sporting Native American headdresses in tribute to Native Americans, as if there aren't Native American models. You think Chanel would have took a note from the Victoria's Secret fashion show back in 2013 when Karlie Kloss had the Native American headdress on, which you would think that they would learn from their mistakes, but you know what? They probably figured, this isn't racist. We're white guys who love fashion, and we're just trying to pay tribute to Texas history. Now, next up, we have the Adidas shoe company. Now, the reason I picked Adidas is because every Black History Month and every year, it turns out to be a bust. Now, if you didn't already see the new Uncaged that Adidas released for the Black History Month collection, because they released a all-white shoe that did not sit well with customers, and of course the fact that the shoe was called Uncaged, people thought that was really stupid. Adidas said that they were trying to emulate like jazz shoes that you would see like jazz club. They posted like a picture of Langston Hughes and some white loafers saying like, hey, that's what we were going for, even though those are loafers and we made sneakers. In another Black History Month where Adidas just bombed, back in 2012 they released this cartoony orange shoe that basically had like a huge chain attached to it for their Black History Month shoe. It's a sneaker with a chain. I mean, you just saw it. There's really nothing that needs to be said about this one. I don't know how that even became a thing. And lastly, we are going to touch on Viktor & Rolf. The Swedish fashion company decided that they were gonna paint their models in blackface for a 2001 runway show. Now, originally they said their inspiration was black holes because they absorb energy and light. There was nothing about space in the show. I found no connecting theme, so I don't know how they pulled that out of their ass. Now, I don't remember if this gained a whole lot of traction because I was born in 1997 and this happened in 2001, but a lot of the articles that I read were basically saying that they made a huge fashion statement. Black holes are so cool and exciting. Oh, they're such fun Swedish fashion designers. Oh yeah, whatever. And that's it. That's all I got for you. Thank you guys so much for watching today's video. If you liked it, please, please, please hit that huge like button. And if you like me and think I'm not a racist fashion designer, which I'm not either of those things, hit that subscribe button as well as turning on my post notifications to make sure you don't miss any of my videos. If you haven't checked out my last video, please do so. And comment below if you like this type of video, if you want to see me do more fashion designers, or you know, just brands, companies in general that have made like racist topics. You know, I'm so open to what you want to see. Also, I want subscribers and more views, so holla at your girl. You guys stay tight and I'll see you another late night. Bye.
Did you like and subscribe?